Starting from this video, we will look at the attention networks, which is the 11th topic of deep learning. In this video, we'll look at the sequence-to-sequence networks. This video was produced in Korean and translated into English. My voice is generated by AI, text-to-speech. Let's look at the full table of contents. This topic covers sequence-to-sequence, attention, and transformer networks. These are mainly used in natural language processing, NLP, but in this tutorial, we will apply them to time series forecasting. In later NLP courses, we will explore these in more detail and use them to create machine translator or chatbots. In Chapter 1, we will look at a sequence-to-sequence network model consisting of an RNN encoder-decoder. First, let's look at the architecture of this model. And let's look at how to create a time series dataset to train this model. This dataset will be also used for the attention model and transformer model in chapters 2 and 3. And let's look at the training and the prediction stage. In the training stage, a method called teacher forcing is used. Finally, let's implement this model to predict a time series. In Chapter 2, let's upgrade the existing sequence-to-sequence model by adding the attention feature. We will look at the structure of the sequence-to-sequence attention network and how to find the attention scores and attention values. We will walk through the training and prediction processes and implement an attention model for time series forecasting. In Chapter 3, we will look at the transformer model. The transformer consists of a self-attention-based encoder and decoder rather than an RNN-based encoder-decoder structure. The transformer is also designed for natural language processing. However, here, we will remove the word embedding layer from the original transformer structure and modify some of the padding mask functions to apply them to time series prediction. Let's look at the training and prediction processes and implement a transformer model for time series prediction. Now, let's look at the RNN encoder-decoder model. In 2014, Kyung-Yen Cho et al. Proposed RNN encoder-decoder model in their paper, Learning Phrase Representations Using RNN Encoder-Decoder for Statistical Machine Translation. Since it deals with sequence data, it is also called a sequence-to-sequence model. Let's read the abstract of this paper. In this paper, we propose a novel neural network model called RNN encoder-decoder that consists of two recurrent neural networks, RNN. One RNN encodes a sequence of symbols into a fixed length vector representation, and the other decodes the representation into another sequence of symbols. This paper deals with sequences of word representation vectors for natural language processing, but we will deal with sequences of real valued vectors for time series analysis. The RNN encoder-decoder model proposed in this paper is as follows. Both the encoder and decoder consist of recurrent neural networks. The output C of the encoder is fed to the decoder as the initial hidden state. Now let's take a closer look at the sequence-to-sequence model. This model can be applied to any dataset that consists of sequences, such as machine translation, chatbots, and time series forecasting. Both the encoder and decoder are composed of RNNs, such as GRU and LSTM. RNNs can be constructed as single or multilayer, and uni or bidirectional. This figure shows a two-layered unidirectional model. The final hidden states H and C of the encoder are fed as the initial hidden states of the decoder. Both feature X and target Y in the dataset are sequence data. The feature X is input to the encoder, and the target Y is output to the decoder. For the task of time series forecasting, X can be a past time series and Y can be a future time series. For chatbots in the field of natural language processing, X and Y are conversation data. Feature X can be question sentences, and target Y can be answer sentences. X and Y can be sentences or speech. For machine translation, X could be English, and Y could be the translated Korean. These are all sequence data. Next, let's look at how to construct the training data for time series prediction. This dataset is the time series we used in the previous series, recurrent neural networks. This dataset consists of two features, X1 and X2, each of which is a sine curve with Gaussian noise like this. Let's use this dataset to generate training data for a sequence-to-sequence model. The encoder and decoder each have 5 time steps. The number of time steps need not be the same. First, we generate subsets to be fed into the encoder as follows. We generate the first subset of 5 sequences from the original time series. Then we slide this window down 1 step to generate the second subset of 5 sequences. We continue to generate these subsets in this way. Next, we generate subsets to be fed into the decoder as follows. The first data point in each subset is the last data point in the encoder input. And the next 4 sequences follow. Finally, we generate the subsets that will be output to the decoder. We generate a decoder output subset from the following 5 sequences of the encoder input subset. These are all 3-dimensional data. The first dimension is the batch size, or the number of subsets. The next dimension is the number of time steps. And the last dimension is the number of features. Now let's feed these datasets into this model. Feed the first subset of encoder inputs to the encoder. This is a past time series. And we feed the first subset of decoder inputs into the decoder. The input to the first time step of the decoder is the input to the final time step of the encoder. This is the value of the current data point. And let the decoder output a sequence of the first subset of the decoder outputs. This is the future time series. The subsets of the decoder inputs are used only during training and are used for teacher forcing, which we will explore on the next page. Then, this becomes a model that takes a past time series as input and outputs a future time series. Next, let's look at the training process. The encoder and decoder are combined into a single model and trained using a method called teacher forcing. The encoder receives a past time series and outputs hidden states. When using GRU, only H is output. And when using LSTM, H and C are output. These hidden states are fed into the decoder as initial states. The decoder uses the hidden states of the encoder and the input values of the decoder to output the target Y. Since the target Y must be output at each time step, the decoder must be configured as a many-to-many RNN. The gradients of the loss with respect to each parameter are backpropagated through time from each time step of the decoder to the first time step of the encoder. The first time step of the decoder takes the final value of the encoder input. This causes the next value of the encoder input to be output at the first time step of the decoder. And in the decoder, the output of the previous time step must be fed into the next time step. However, since the output of the previous time step is the predicted value, during training, known values that are more accurate than the predicted value are input to the next time step. This is why we use the subsets of the decoder input. This is the teacher forcing. However, during prediction, since the future sequences are unknown, the outputs of the previous time steps must be fed into the next time steps. Once training is complete, we save the trained parameters so they can be used in the prediction model. Finally, let's look at the prediction process. The training process is relatively simple because it uses teacher forcing, but the prediction process is somewhat complex. We use the following procedure to predict future time series. First, build an encoder model for prediction. Instead of creating a new encoder, we should use a previously trained encoder. And feed the last 5 data points of the time series into the model. And find the final hidden states. The final hidden states contain all the information about this sequence data. We want to use this hidden states to predict the future time series. Second, we build a single-step decoder model for prediction. As with the encoder model, instead of creating a new decoder, we need to use a previously trained decoder. Since the parameters of an RNN are independent of the number of time steps, the parameters of a single-step RNN and a multi-step RNN are the same. Then we feed the hidden states of the encoder and the value of the final data point of the time series into this model. This input acts as a kind of seed value. Then we can get the next hidden states and the next predicted value. Third, we feed the next hidden states and predicted value of the first decoder back into the single-step decoder model. Then we can get the next hidden states and the next predicted value. By repeating this process a given number of times, we can predict future time series. This is how to predict time series using the sequence-to-sequence model. So far, we have looked at the structure of the sequence-to-sequence model and how to construct the dataset. And we have looked at the teacher forcing method in the training stage and the prediction process. In the next video, we will implement this model with Keras and predict a real-time series.